The year right now is 2025. Both Ryzen 3400G and 4300G are quite old CPUs now, and they should only be considered for budget or media PC builds. Ryzen 3400G was released in late 2019, and 4300G was released in middle of 2020. The age of the two CPUs is quite similar. Even their model numbers are similar, but these two are very different CPUs from each other. Say that you are building a cheap computer. You haven't got much coins, and you are scraping the bottom of the barrel for money. Yet you want some sort of gaming capacity. Unfortunately, in such a scenario, a dedicated GPU is just out of the question. APU, AMD's G-class CPU, is your only visible option. The bare minimum I recommend in 2025 is a Zen 2 APU, which is Ryzen 4000 series. However, Ryzen 3400G should also be considered. If you compare the spec of both CPUs, you may find that 3400G has an objectively better iGPU. At the same time, Zen 2 is so much better than Zen Plus by about 15% per core. In short, Zen 2 core is objectively superior. So, both CPUs have its own strength. Thus, this comes down to the question of whether to prioritize CPU or GPU. You are seeing the two CPUs in question right now in front of you. I am going to install Windows 11, install Steam, and fire up two games to see whether the superior iGPU of 3400G matters. While the gap might seem big on paper, the actual gap in reality might not be as big due to Zen 2 core being much more powerful, not to mention the possibility of more refined iGPU cores, so let's get on with the testing. But a bit of a disclaimer here. I won't tweak any BIOS settings. Everything will be run on default settings. And rebar will be disabled, although I don't think it has any effect on APUs. 4300G has a single core score of 1561 and multi-core score of 5303. Its GPU score is 12172. In contrast, 3400G has a single core score of 1247 and multi-core score of 4003. But it has a GPU score of 16057. The result is clear. 3400G has a much better iGPU on paper. But how will that translate into real-world gaming? I am going to play two games, Crusader Kings 3 and Conan Exiles. While playing Crusader Kings 3 on both CPUs, I did feel that 3400G had an objectively smoother gameplay, and it did show from the frame rates. It's 30fps for 3400G and 20fps for 4300G. It may be a difference of just 10fps, but 30fps is the minimum required for what's perceived as a smooth gameplay. So you want at least 30fps in any games, with 60fps being ideal. We are talking about low-end gaming here, so please don't expect 120fps gaming. While playing Conan Exiles, it was a bit more complicated. On low graphic setting, both performed similarly, with about 25 FPS average indoors and 40 FPS average outdoors. On medium setting, I did find that 3400 APU was slightly better by about several frames per second. It wasn't much, and the difference was within margin of error, to be honest. In conclusion, Ryzen 3400 APU is better as long as games you are playing is not demanding. Once you are playing full 3D games, both APUs went down to about the same lows. At the same time, Zen Plus Core of 3400 is showing its age. I say this because the Geekbench single core score is similar to that of Intel Celeron N100. And it took 5 minutes for Crusader Kings 3 start. I did state that Zen 2 was the minimum you should get, and this is why. But if gaming is your top priority, then 3400 APU makes sense because you will have better frame rates once games are loaded. For any other general usages, I do feel that 4300 APU is the choice due to its objectively superior CPU cores. If you are willing to spend more, Ryzen 4600 APU is probably the way to go. However, the price difference is a bit large. I was able to acquire 4300 for $45. 4600 costs twice more. 3400 APU costs roughly the same as 4300, and that is why I've made this video to compare the both of them. If I were to choose between them, I'd go for Ryzen 4300 APU simply due to its better CPU core. I want better general computing experience than gaming, to be completely honest. Anyway, that is it for this video. Thank you for watching and see you next time.